There comes a time in almost everyone's life when they look in the mirror and realize they aren't quite the person they were 20 years ago. You get a little heavier, you're not quite as athletic, but hey, 2 decades will take a toll on anyone. The same thing could be said for the Nissan Maxima. 20 years ago, it was the four-door sports car. Lean, athletic, fun to drive. But over the years, it's gotten heavier, it's not quite as much fun to drive. You could even say it's a little pudgy around the middle. The great thing about cars is they can be reinvented, and that's what Nissan's trying to do with the all-new Maxima.
To help reclaim its sporty identity, the first thing engineers did was to give the Maxima more power. It uses the same 3.5-liter V6 found in the previous version, but through some serious retuning, the new car puts out 290 horsepower and 261 pound-feet of torque. That's 35 more horses and 9 more pound-feet of torque than the previous model. Power is routed to the front wheels through a continuously variable transmission, now featuring a special DS mode on sport models, which when used, enhances sport driving with better acceleration, automatic engine braking, and improved performance while cornered.
Since the Maxima is a sports sedan, Nissan really wanted to communicate that with the styling, and for the most part they did a good job. You have these nice wide fenders that look really muscular, you have a nice low hood line, 18-inch wheels are standard, you can get 19-inchers as part of an option package, a broad, aggressive, blunt nose, and then you have these headlights. Now, far and away, this is what people are going to look at when they see the new Maxima. Nissan calls them L-shaped, but am I the only one that sees lobster claws? Now the Maxima has the power and it has some interesting styling, but what about just overall performance? Well, there's a couple of things that kind of bother me. Number one is this transmission. The only one you can get is a continuously variable automatic, not exactly an enthusiast's first choice. Now, to their credit, Nissan's given it a manual shift control. You can even get paddles up on the steering wheel, but still, somebody who likes to drive is really going to want a manual transmission, and you can't get it in this car. The second thing is the suspension. It's pretty lumpy on roads that are a little rougher. Now, you can accept that in a sports sedan if there's a handling payoff, but in this one, there really isn't. It's okay, but the car is still all over itself. There's too much roll, it bounces around too much and bumps and that kind of thing. So there's really not that kind of payoff. Is it a real sports sedan? Well, it's pretty good, but I was really hoping for more. So the question is, has Nissan revived the four-door sports car with the new Maxima? Well, they certainly come close. This Maxima is a lot more fun to drive than any other Maxima in recent history. It's got more power, it's got a lot of interesting features inside. However, sitting next to it on the showroom floor is the Altima. Now the Altima is about the same size, it's a little bit down on power, and it doesn't have all the same bells and whistles, but it's still quite a bit of fun to drive. Our advice, before you sign on the dotted line, just make sure you drive both. For MyRide.com, I'm Keith Buglewitz. We'll see you next time.